Students, we have seen multiplication of two negative numbers. So I am going to do same thing now. So whenever we'll multiply minus 1 into minus 1, what will be the answer? 1 ones are 1 and negative negative becomes positive. That will be the answer. Now this was just a simple multiplication. In further step, what I am going to do, I am going to divide this whole equation by minus 1. So whenever I will divide this side, LHS, this is the right hand side, by minus 1, always remember to divide with the same number on the right hand side also. Because if you don't divide on both the sides, then that sum will be wrong. So I will divide by using some different color. So I will divide this side also by minus 1, and when I divide on LHS also by minus 1, right hand side also I have to divide by minus 1. Now students, I have already told you, when the same number is there in the numerator, so this is the numerator and this is the denominator. So in numerator and denominator, there is one same number which repeats. Which is that number? Yes, it is minus 1. So minus 1 is here also and minus 1 is here also. So when one number repeats itself in numerator and denominator, we can cut that number. Okay, and what remains now? Only minus 1 is remaining, which was extra. So we'll write down the equation again. Minus 1, which is remaining here, equal to, write down this part also, 1 upon minus 1. Okay, so with this simple division or with this simple calculation, what was the intention? So the intention was, whenever we divide positive integer, this is positive 1, by negative number, always keep in mind the denominator should never have negative sign. The negative sign should always be there in the numerator. So the quotient is what? Quotient means answer. 1 divided by minus 1, what is the answer? Equal to minus 1. Why? Because this minus sign goes in the numerator. So if we pass this minus sign in numerator, what will happen? I'll write down again minus sign, I'll pass in numerator. So here it will be minus 1. And what will remain in the denominator? Only 1. Right? Because I have passed this minus sign up in the numerator. Right? So divided by minus 1, we can also make this 1 vanish. It does not count. Whenever any number is divided by 1, we can write 1 or we can also make it vanish also, because 1 does not count. So what will be the answer? Only numerator, because 1 does not count in the denominator. So the answer is minus 1. So you can see here LHS is equal to RHS. So the intention to do this calculation was to tell you all that whenever we divide positive integer by negative integer, always minus sign you have to write in the numerator. That is the only part you have to remember. Okay, so let us see some more examples related to this. So you can see here, first thing is to divide any positive integer by negative integer. So what is, for example, I have taken here 7 is positive integer and I have divided by negative integer, which is minus 2. So let us see what will be the answer. First thing you have to do is check whether both this number, numerator and denominator, numbers which are there, do they come in one common table? So 2 comes in 2's table, 2 ones are 2. But in 2's table, does 7 come? No. So both this number which are there, they don't come in one common table. So this division is going to remain in the same manner. But one rule I have told you all in previous calculation was, always never write negative sign in the denominator. You have to write in the numerator. So what you have to do? You have to keep this number as it is. Only this minus sign you have to pass it in the numerator. So what will be the answer? Equal to minus 7 upon 2. So you can see here, this minus sign I have passed in the numerator. That is the easiest way. So this is the answer that you get when you divide a positive integer by negative integer. always negative integer sign, you have to pass it in the numerator. As simple as that. Okay, now let us see another point. I'll use another pen. Okay, what is the another point or another topic? To divide any negative integer by a negative integer. Now we are dividing. So see, in this first example, we are dividing negative integer minus 13 by negative integer minus 2. Now what do we have to do? We have to, again, don't have to write negative sign in the denominator, but there is this trick. Like I said, whatever number repeats itself in the numerator as well as denominator, that we can cut. Here, what is repeated in numerator and denominator? Minus minus sign is repeated. So whenever there are two minus sign in the numerator as well as denominator, that minus sign gets cancelled. And whatever answer we get is just the numbers 13 divided by 2. Okay, so whenever there are two minus sign in numerator and denominator, it becomes plus. Okay. And whenever there is only one minus sign, which is there in the denominator, it goes to the numerator. That you have to keep in mind. Okay. So numerator is positive, denominator is negative. Whenever there is positive and negative, always negative sign remains. And whenever there is negative, negative, what becomes? It becomes positive. Okay. So let us solve similar type of another sum. So negative minus, so minus 25 divided by minus 4. What will happen? Again, minus minus sign will get cut and will get answer as 25 upon 4. So whenever you get this answer, students, always you have to check whether you can simplify this integer. Simplify means what? You have to check whether numerator as well as denominator, both these numbers which are there, whether they come in one common table. So 25 and 4, do they come in one common table? No. If you check in 2's table, 3's table, 4's table, in 4 table itself also, 4 ones of 4 can come. But in 4's table, we cannot get 25, right? So that's how the answer will remain same. Also, here also, if you check in first sum, 13 divided by 2, we do not have any number in which we get 2 as well as 13. In the table in which we get 2 as well as 13. In 2's table, if you see, 2 1's are 2, 2 2's are 4, 2 3's are 6, 2 4's are 8, 2 5's are 10, 2 6's are 12, 2 7's are 14. So you can see here 13 does not come. 12 comes and 14 comes, but 13 does not come. So we don't have any table in which both this number are there. So the answer will remain same. But let us solve third sum here and let us see what will happen. Again, what you can do is, first thing you have to do is cancel the minus sign. So what will I get? Equal to 18 upon 2. Okay. This answer will become plus because there are two minus sign in numerator as well as denominator. So we'll get plus 18 upon 2. Now what you have to do is check whether both this number 2 and 18 come in one table or not. So 2 comes in which table? 2's table. 2 ones are 2. And in 2's table, do you get 18 also? Yes, you get 18 also. So in one, which one common table both this number are there? In 2's table. So I will write down 2 what's are 18? 2 9's are 18 and divided by 2 1's are 2, right? So 18 I have written as 2 9's are 18 and 2 I have written as 2 1's are 2. So you can see here one common table, both we get both the number. So what have I told you all? When in numerator and denominator, when we have same number, we can cancel. So what will be the final answer? 2 2 gets cancelled. So 9 upon 1 is remaining. And 9 upon 1, when 1 is there in the denominator, only numerator we can write down as the answer, which is 9. Similar sum, you can do it in the form of normal division also. So 18 divided by 2. You have to write down like this. So 2 9's are 18 and the remainder is 0. When the remainder is 0, the answer is this quotient. Similar answer we get. So there are two ways in which you can do the division. This way also it is possible and this way also it is possible. Whichever way you find out simple, you can do it in that manner. So, but this manner is very simple. Both the numerator and denominator, whatever numbers are there, you have to first see both this number come in which one common table, which one common table. Okay, and then you have to write down their multiplication form, that table. Okay, so 2 9s are 18 and 2 1s are 2. So that's how we divide the negative and positive integers. Both these topics, I hope it is clear to everyone. Now moving towards next part. This instruction which is there, or this point which is there, it is very very important. So what is that point? Let us see. I'll use another pen. Yeah. When one integer is divided by another by non-zero integer. Okay, so whenever we divide by some non-zero integer, it is minus 2 or 1 or minus 3, but never we have divided by 0. So it should be a non-zero integer. When one integer is divided by another non-zero integer, it is customary to write the denominator of the quotient, that is answer, as a positive integer. So like I have told you earlier also, always in this instruction what is said, the denominator which is there, it should never have negative sign, it should always have positive sign. So in this example, you can see in denominator there is negative sign. So what we should do, we should pass it in the numerator. So the answer will be what? Minus 7 upon 2. We have passed this negative sign up. In this example, what do we have to do? When up numerator or as well as denominator, when we have negative negative sign, what becomes? What will be the answer? Negative negative sign gets cancelled and the answer will be 11 upon 3. So in this case also denominator is positive, and in this case also denominator is positive. So then we have applied the rule correctly. Okay. Never don't write denominator in negative integer. Okay. Always denominator should be positive. Keep this rule properly in your mind.